Well, for years we've known that Marc-Andre Fleury is an elite goaltender in the National Hockey League, a premier goalie, but his numbers haven't always reflected that. Now they're starting to reflect it. And he's always had top winning numbers. He leads the league with 20 of those. But our Kia starting goaltender is now fifth in goals against average, and he's also in the top 10 in save percentage.
And he's also doing it without the team's top four defense in the lineup. And that's key for Marc-Andre Fleury. He's been spectacular. The Hyundai starting goaltender, Kari Ramo, 0-3 in his career against the Penguins. There's his numbers this season. And Bob Hartley, the bench boss, second year behind Calgary's bench.
Former winner of the Stanley Cup with the Colorado Avalanche. And, of course, Dan Bylsma finding ways to win with a lineup that is featuring a lot of, well, I'd say former baby Penguins because they've grown up fast. Sidney Crosby against Michael Backlund to start the hockey game. It'll be Backlund starting the game with Camilleri and Byron on his wings. Ladislav Schmid and Giordano on defense. For the Penguins, Crosby, Dupuis and Kunitz, Robert Bortuzzo and Brian Dumoulin defensively. And the referees, Dave Jackson and John A. Bear, Brad Kovalchuk. Matt McPherson are the linesmen. And Crosby will slap the puck into the Calgary zone.
Calgary has been in Pittsburgh, and in that game, Crosby had a shorthanded and an empty net goal, and that's the last time he has scored in the empty net or scored a shorty.
Kunitz, Crosby, shot, where is it? Ramo looked back, but he was right there at his left pad, and he's able to freeze it. He thought it was
there. Giordano tried to clear, he went down, the puck up the wall, and the Flames able to get it to center, and Camilleri with it there.
He wears a lucky 13 for the Flames. Now Fleury sends it around to the far side, and Kunitz tips it over for Mana. He lost control of it. Shot back to the net. And the save made by Fleury on Backlund.
Well, they don't have the skill level, obviously, of the Pittsburgh Penguins. They're going to make all the simple plays, get pucks to the net, play physical, hope for a power play or a penalty kill.
Vitali feeds the puck into the corner. Jokinen sends it back around far side for Craig Adams, a native Calgarian. Jokinen centers it off the goalpost. Neil fired it. It wasn't a goal. It looked like it went in and out, but it hit the goalpost. Neil came that close to making it 1-0.
Yeah, the puck was fluttering, and it really hit dead on that goalpost. Had good velocity, but it just hit flat and laid there.
Russell to Brody, a one-timer, and it didn't get anything on that shot as it hit Sill. It comes from the near side. Bortuzzo tried to clear Byron to Backlund. Good save, rebound. Another save by Fleury on Backlund. Out to Russell now. Drags to the middle and shoots it. Hit a man down low. And Camilleri was gunning for one as he came in tight. It stayed out. Now it's Russell with it again. Shane O'Brien dumps the puck into the Penguin zone. Fleury leaves it there for Philip Samuelson. And around now for Matt Niskanen. A lead pass steered in by Kunitz. Crosby comes on the ice. He's kind of stealthy right now as he came on off the bench. Now he gets to the puck. Kunitz to Dupuis, closely checked. Crosby looks for it, shoots it, sir! Rebound, they score! Dupuis got to the net. It came squirting out from behind the goaltender. And Dupuis cleaning up the garbage to give the Penguins a 1-0 lead and scoring his seventh of the season. He's got four goals in his last nine games. Here's Neal to the net. He shoots it. Ramo the save, and he covers it up. James Neal working the corner. Up top it goes to Robert Bortuzzo. Up high now, Zolnarchuk. Bortuzzo down to the goal line. Now it's the Penguins controlling the puck in the offensive zone. Bortuzzo, he scores! It was deflected in. I think Zolnarchuk's going to get the goal. We'll see.
Oh, I think you got it.
You got to have a relationship between the four players on the ice, and you got a good angle.
Flames desperately need one here, and Camilleri, a very dangerous player, shoots the puck there, and Fleury makes the save. Camilleri has two of power play goals, two of his 10 for the Flames. Here's Backlund with a slap shot. Fleury the save, and he covers the rebound.
You got to have good face-offs. You got to have good clears. You got to have in the lane, sticks in the lane, and bodies in the lane.
This is TJ Brody with it. He'll gain the red line and slap it around hard. Jones over to get it. He chopped it off the boards. There's Connor trying to clear. So was Jokinen. He overskated, though, and it comes out to Butler, and his shot. Fleury the save.
And Jones was hovering, looking for a rebound, but Fleury froze the puck. Taken there by Chris Russell. A little Brody with 5 seconds to go. Here's Backlund, defended by Dumoulin, who's got the puck. And the period comes to an end. So another lead for the Penguins after the first period. They're 14-1 when they lead after one. They had two goals on five shots, Bob.
Yeah, and the Flames at the end of this road trip with a hard-working first period of play. They have one injured who won't come back, and the Penguins are up by two. It's a tough mountain for the team to climb.
The 0-2-0-3 season, if you averaged out all the years, they finished right in the middle of the pack. That's the classic example of mediocrity. And I think the Flames as an organization under Brian Burke, and they're looking for a new general manager, have come to the conclusion that you do have to sometimes bite the bullet and go down to the bottom to get back up to the top. And that's what they're going to try to do. They're in a rebuilding mode right now.
And they're 27th in goals against. They have to improve that because they don't score a lot of goals. Hudler's their main guy with 30 points.
For years, they relied on Mika Kiprusoff to keep them in games. He would play, if not more, almost more than anybody in the league, year in and year out. Jones has gone 9 games without a goal. Dumoulin sends it out ahead to Neal to try to angle one to Connor. Picked up by Jokinen down the wing. Drops it off to Neal. Neal turns, shoots, and a save by Ramo, and he freezes it. Ramo had that paddle down early, and Neal shot the puck right into that paddle.
It's weird that he had the paddle down early.
Schmid held it into the corner. And the Giordano blast and a good pat stop made by Fleury, and the rebound cleared by Sill. And the Flames can't control in the neutral zone as Olimata goes across to Matt Niskanen. Snaps it out on right wing. Adams across the rink for Sill to the net, and Ramo controls the rebound with Kobosu heading that way. Byron couldn't control the puck. It's picked up now on the left wing by Chris Kunitz, who dumps it up into the Calgary zone. Ramo has to wait for it to come to the trapezoid. Now it's taken by Dupuis. Kunitz was open, but Dupuis unable to really control the puck to get it to him, and now Crosby tries to do that. Crosby turning, looking at Kunitz. He directs it to the net. Penalty coming up. Fleury's headed to the bench. Penguins get an extra attacker on. It's James Neal. Crosby behind the net. Crosby tried to go to Neal, but deflecting it away is Michael Backlund, and the Penguins will put that prolific power play to work. Jokinen to Neal. Neal swinging around Brody. Over to Kunitz. Trying to control it on the wall. Kunitz for Neal. Good hustle by Neal. To Dumoulin. To Crosby. Oh! It just went over the stick of Crosby and wide of the goal.
Dumoulin head up. Look for that stick of Crosby on the backhand.
Jokinen closes in. Back up top to Brian Dumoulin. To Crosby. A shot of the save by Ramo. He read the play beautifully. And the Flames able to clear, and they'll go back to the bench and replace all penalty killers. And the Penguins get their second power play unit onto the ice with 39 seconds remaining on the penalty to Mark Giordano. He gets to the bench. He's replaced by Simone Desprez, who's hit by Backlund, but now stripped of the puck by Stempniak. He's got two shorthanded goals. He shoots it in a save made by Fleury. Sutter got nailed by Giordano. Came right, stepped out of the penalty box.
Oh boy, you couldn't see it at all. I mean, that is tough. And Bortuzzo up, giving a little lip service to Giordano right now.
Shot. Colburn off of Fleury's equipment and poked just wide of the goal. It was Byron who had that chance. Now Butler to the corner for Colburn. For Paul Byron. Flames buzzing right now in the Penguin zone. Byron fires off the goal post and it goes in. It hit Fleury, went over the line. And the Flames, through hard work, after a solid penalty kill, have made it a 2-1 hockey game. Olimata for Neal. Neal cuts into the slot, trying to pull the trigger, and it's knocked away to the near side. Neal gets it back, though. Penalty coming up. Fleury to the bench. Extra attacker going to be coming on here. He has to go all the way across the red line as Desprez shoots the puck. It's off a stick and to the corner, and the Penguins maintain possession. Crosby. Bortuzzo holds it. Desprez takes it. Slap shot coming up. Deflected to the front of the net. Put it there. And Shane O'Brien stepped in to get a hold of it. To draw the whistle, and the Penguins will put their power play on the ice in a moment.
Plus 21 in the season. Leads all blue liners in the National Hockey League.
Tied with Francois Beauchemin in that category.
And here's Niskanen with it to the near side, and Crosby. Now a shot by Neal to stop. Rebound. Kunitz whacked at it, but it's going to be frozen by Carey Ramo. How about that release by Neal?
No, great release. Didn't get it up as much as he wanted to with Ramo going down.
Here's Crosby with it now, and he'll take it. Turn away from Stajan. Works it to the point. And then Jokinen to Niskanen to drive. And a save by Ramo. That's what I'm talking about. He just He just has that gun cocked, and he's ready to fire as soon as it gets to him.
Yeah, and Kunitz is right in front of Rommel, and we know what Kunitz can do in front of that net.
Not a snap it through the slot. It comes off the corner boards. And out to the point, Dumoulin again across. Olimata with a blast, and a save by Rommel. The rebound to the corner. Sutter will get there. Dupuis is hanging around behind the net right now. Sutter gets him the puck. He steps out. Now to Sutter. Sutter back out for Dupuis. The shot, save made, and the rebound. This control by the Flames. It was a good save by Rama, who took that high off his chest.
Well, he's
now it's going to be dumped in by Byron.
Yeah, he's really down early, Staggy Rama. I mean, you got to elevate that puck if you can.
And Vitali able to chop it off the corner glass to the near side. Brody got there first. Moves it out to Camilleri. The slap shot. Fleury the save. The rebound. Oh, Fleury made a good save on the short side on Russell, who moved up on the play. And Bortuzzo flattens him against the glass. And now Hudler's got it. And Hudler goes down to his knees. Bortuzzo working. So is Joe Vitale to get it free for Philip Samuelson. With 5:27 remaining in the second period. Solid hit by Simone Dupre there on Lee Stepniak, number 22. One-handed ahead now to Crosby. Look at that move around Brody. Down the wing. He fires. He scores. Dumoulin with a nice outlet pass to Crosby, who reaches back for it. Tolbert trying to check him as he comes into the slot. Puck comes off a leg to Samuelson. Settles it down and shoots it. Rebound. Well, Kunitz was there. I think the first shot, though, was gloved by the goaltender Ramo before Kunitz could look for a rebound. The far corner, Kunitz overskated. Neil hustles over to get to it for Crosby. Tried to go to Kunitz, and it was broken up by the Flame. David Jones takes it down. And his pass intercepted by Bortuzzo right to Crosby. Crosby holds it, drops it back to Niskanen, and his shot, score! I think Niskanen will get this goal, and the Penguins lead it 4-1.
Now, James Neal getting a shot with the Crosby unit.
And that will be the third of the season, second in two games for Matt Niskanen. And the Penguins up by three. And the Flames have allowed more than three goals only once in the last 14 games. They score here, though, as Camilleri gets his obligatory goal against the Penguins to make it 4-2.
The Camel's back.
And the Penguins dump it in, and time expires here in the second period. The shots are even at 18 now. The Penguins with 13 in that second period to 8 for the Flames, and the Penguins lead it by 2. And from the opening faceoff here in the third period, the centering pass to Pui shoots it and it's blocked. And Camilleri moves it to the right wing. It'll be taken there by Paul Byron, who dumps it to the right wing corner. Fleury shovels it along up the near side. It was very cold in the building earlier. It feels as though it's gotten a little warmer. Here's a backhand pass through the slot by Yuri Hudler. And up the near wall, centering pass, shot. Stajan gunned it wide of the goal and off the corner boards. Brody held it in. Flames on a mission here. They're looking to get that next goal. They do. They score. Yuri Hudler bangs it home behind Fleury. And the Flames come out with some energy, and that pays off. They get it back to within one. Kunitz shoots the puck off a leg. Dupuis tries to get to the puck. Barreling into that slot area. He just couldn't get a hold of it. Now Crosby goes down on his back, gets back up. On top of the puck is Giordano. Coming over to pry it free is Kunitz. Now Crosby with a reverse hit on Giordano has the puck. Moves it out to Dupre. Dupre's shot, and the save made by Remo. A rebound to Kunitz. Now a penalty coming up.
Yeah, this is going to come against Sidney Crosby against Giordano. And this, you know, this started in Calgary about 3 or 4 years ago. And it's continuing here tonight.
Back into the corner, Joe Colburn up top. Brody with it. Back for Colburn. Colburn centers. And Adams tried to clear, but it comes right to Brody. Brody holds it. Moves it right side. Butler shoots it. And Fleury saw that one. Boy, there were some Flames around there before he was able to find that puck through traffic. Off the draw, it is controlled by the Flames with the 15 seconds to go on the penalty. Russell plays catch at the point, and the shot by Giordano stopped by Fleury. Rebound covered up, and Dupre pushes the Flame right out of there. Samuelson took a good glove to the face. I think Camilleri popped him with one.
Yeah, he just popped him again.
The Penguins trying to get Camilleri away from the net.
Flames end up controlling it. Down low. It is Hudler centering it, and it goes right through the slot off the boards, and Crosby comes right out of the box. Here's Crosby with Jokinen going to the net. His shot. Glove save made by Ramo. He didn't catch it, though. Centering for Adams, who was tripped as the puck came to him a little bit by Backlund. He just got a stick in there to interrupt the ability of Adams to catch that pass. Now it's Crosby with a shooting. Oh, he just sailed that one high and wide as Ramo was off his angle. Now Neal pokes it back into the corner. Crosby over to play it against Butler. Crosby tried to go to Kunitz. It's off a stick and out the center. The right wing, Stempniak for Hudler. And Niskanen just skated over and stripped Hudler of the puck. Sends it back into the corner. Olimata's there. Flames read the reverse on the shot by Stajan. Stopped by Fleury. Fleury with a great save on Stajan after the Flames had read the reverse behind the net by the Penguins and picked it off. Now Camilleri with it. And he'll send it up into the corner, and Samuelson goes back for it.
Pressure, 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 pressure. They read that as well. Camilleri stole it.
Giordano shoots it, and a blocker save made by Fleury. Now it's Backlund with it. He tries to center. Here's Byron pulling up. He looks for Backlund. Stepping up on him, though, was Dupre, and he finds Crosby down the wing against Giordano. He fires it up. Save made by Ramo. Crosby would have loved nothing more than to score there. Now Dupuis with a blast, and he fires it wide. And he comes back into the corner and in behind the net. Crosby to Dupuis. He shoots it. Ramo telescoped out to make a big save. Up pass to Dupuis to keep his game and his team in it. And now the puck is dumped to the corner. Adams after it. Lance Boma steps in to get to it. Dupre leans on him, and Colburn has the puck, steps in front, hit the goal post. It's loose behind Fleury, and it's going to be frozen at the side of the cage. That puck did everything but go across the goal line. And the gloves fly.
And how did it stay out? What a power move. Was that Colburn with a big long reach?
Olimata. Head to Adams, who just tips it into the Calgary zone. Ramo wants to come out of the net. He's already leading the net with the puck in his own end. And that's really surprising that he would leave at that point with a minute 17 to go. But no damage done to the Flames. Boy, that puck was still in the danger zone there. Now Camilleri with it, the center. Moves it to the right wing. Colburn looks for Camilleri to shot. Flurry to save. Rebound Colburn. Flurry flops to the ice. He has the puck frozen. The Flames don't think so, but the referee lost sight of it and he blew the whistle.
It was underneath Marc-Andre Fleury. Did he know it was there? I don't know. He just threw somebody's lid, Colburn's lid, right out of that crease area. Colburn went right to the net and tried to plow Marc-Andre Fleury.
Hudler with it behind the net. Back to Camilleri to the point. And a slap pass for Hudler. He tried to redirect it, didn't get a lot on it. And he was leveled in the corner by Niskanen. Big hit. 4 seconds to go. And the Penguins are going to win. Their 10th straight win on home ice. They roll a 7 today. Their 7th win in a row overall. The final score, Pittsburgh 4 and Calgary 3.
Oh, I love the tough hockey right to the bitter end. Niskanen knocking down Hudler in the corner. And the Penguins clearing the house in front of Marc-Andre Fleury when times got tough. And when they were down to 5 defensemen at points in this hockey game, they sucked it up. They got it done. And they were weary, not well rested, but they found a way to get 2 more points.
And they extend their lead to 7 over the Boston Bruins. In the Eastern Conference standings, the Penguins, another tough performance here at home. With a depleted lineup, they get the job done.